Good evening, everyone. Can you hear me? Yes, thank you. Thank you, Tejashwi. Thanks for the connection. Okay. Last class, I have given an assignment regarding the question hybrid inheritance. And I already told you it is a combination of two inheritances, either a multi-level and multiple or hybrid level and hierarchical and multiple inheritance like that. Okay, so anyway, still some students are joining, almost 531, but only 62 only joined. One, see the logic. Once see the program, what I have given here, and can you please tell me which types of inheritances are there in this program? Meanwhile, remaining students may join. So can you please tell me, I have discussed about five types of inheritance in the last class. It's a combination of what and what? Super Bhavani, very good. That's absolutely. Only one student answered Bhavani. What about the remaining guys? I am asking, what are the two types of inheritances are there in the particular example? Tejashwi, of course, but you have to tell another one also. No, Tejashwi. Everyone, please see the program and respond fast. Almost 3 minutes completed. 3 minutes completed, and 81 students have joined till now. No, Supraja. No, Navya. My question is, I am asking the what are the different types of inheritances are there in that. I am asking that question. Yashaswini, that is absolutely true. What you have said, that is absolutely true, Yashaswini. Navya, that is wrong answer. Mahasudha, that is absolutely correct answer, Mahasudha. Very good. Okay, fine. Because time is moving, you know already, because no, Kumari, that is wrong answer. So here the answer is hierarchical and multiple inheritance, because whenever you are giving class car, okay, here class car, it is there, it is a parent class. If you are giving Maruti car like that, Suzuki car like this, this is hierarchical. First of all, after that, I am giving a Benz class, I am giving Maruti and Suzuki, these are the two parent class. This is called multiple inheritance, you know already. Okay, so this is a combination of hierarchical and multiple inheritance. Okay, you can combine any two types, that's not an issue. But so I think one of our student, only three students submitted the assignment other than second CSC. Okay, so other than second CSC, because many students are not doing assignment, I think due to examinations or all, I don't know. So this is submitted by Mr. Dilip from third year ECE. Okay, so very good, Dilip. That's a good program, Dilip Subramaniam. Okay, so and the remaining two students, Bhavani and Veni, submitted the assignment. Only three students submitted the assignment through mail, I am telling. Okay, so remaining students submitted, second CSC students submitted in GL platform, of course. So anyway, and some students submitted in like a different example, because you can take any n number of examples, that's not an issue at all. So you can do in lot of ways, that's not a problem. Okay, so anyway, I will move fast because most of the students join. So you know already, just I will open this notes. You can see here. So here you can see multiple inheritance. For example, two parent class with one child. Okay. So here Benji is a here Benji is a child class like that. You should think like that. Okay. So you know already remaining all these things. So the Benji here, Benji is a object. Small Benji is a object. So Benji dot race. For example, if I am calling the race method. So basically, race method is included in the first class. But it will be automatically called because so here morphology of car means the car properties or whatever the methods we are there in this, so that will be directly you can use that in morphology class. So in that way, so here you can give Benji dot race means so automatically race method will be called. Okay, so that's the reason I am getting it is a race car. It is getting like this. Okay, so then Benji dot race it is completed. Now Benji dot m. So in morphology he is created like method like m. Okay. So now if this is Morty code, it will be displayed like that. Now if I am giving Benji dot S, so then it will be printed like this is 1 minute. This is Suzuki core like that. Okay. So then after that Benji dot B, that means this method will be executed. This is Benji and length is. So he is calling the length method, length variable here. So it, by using object, it is calling. So it is getting like 500 centimeters. And after that he is calling again one print method in length of race car is Benji dot length like that. He is also calling in this way also. So whatever it may, so it will execute it like this. So this is the best example I have seen. So and Bhavani also submitted in a very good program, and Veni also. So this is somewhat similar to my program. That's the reason I have explained this. Okay. So anyway, I will share this through chat box. If anyone not yet completed, you can go through this. Okay. Yeah. So today I would like to move to the new concept. No mention Dilip. So I have to say thank you because you are only doing the assignments. Okay, anyway, let me comment this. So now today I would like to discuss about some new concept that is called polymorphism. So according to before going to polymorphism, according to our syllabus, it is mentioned operator overloading concept is there. So actually these are very easy topics. I think 4 or 5 line program is enough, guys. Okay, but you know already I would like to give an extra functionalities for every program, you know already. Okay, so today also I would like to give another examples related to operator overloading like that. But I will tell you in examination point of view, it's better to use only easy way. Okay, so because I will explain the wrong, I will explain in detail manner. So but you just study only whatever the concept you are familiar. Okay, so coming to the next concept, so according to the syllabus, the concept is there of operator overloading. Okay, so what do you mean by operator overloading? So it is very easy, guys. Okay, in interviews point of view also they will ask the question, what is an operator overloading? Okay, so overloading, actually operator overloading in C++ and Java we use it to call like overloading and overriding. Everybody knows, I think. Okay, it is very important in especially in interview point of view even. Okay, so many interviews are getting like, what is the difference between method overriding and method overloading, what is meant by operator overloading. They will ask such type of questions. Okay, so you should listen. If you have any doubts, you just mention in the chat box. So I will definitely clarify your doubts. Okay, that means for example, operator overloading, as the name itself it is saying that, so whenever you are taking one operator, if it acts like a more than one way, okay, which acts like a more than one way, and it, based on the instances, based on the data type, it will act like a different instances, it will act like a different platform like that. Okay, so for example, you know, for example, if you're taking an example called for example, you know, in movies there is a movie called Aparichitudu. Okay, so in that Vikram acts like a Remo and all, you know already, because he is like Aparichitudu. That means he will be acts like a different roles. Okay, you just think that concept, because whenever you discussed about those cinema dialogues like that, I definitely understand this concept. That's the reason I'm telling this example. Okay, that means one can be act as a different ways. Okay, so that is nothing but operator overloading. Okay, simple thing. So here you can see ability of a single operator to perform more than one operation. to perform based on the class of operands. This is important, guys. Okay, based on the type of operands. Okay, for example, in that movie, you can see whenever he is doing any persons are doing wrong things, he just converted in like a aparichitad. Okay, so you know already. So otherwise, he is like a Ramu, like that. Okay, so in the same way. So here the plus operator, for example, I am taking the plus operator because here the concept is operator overloading. I am taking plus operator, guys. Okay, so you know whenever I am taking two numbers, okay, that means two integers or a floating point numbers, whatever it may be. Okay, so it basically takes like a integer addition or a floating point addition. Okay. For example, it is also used to concatenate two strings, because you can use the plus operator to concatenate two strings as well as make two lists actually. That means you know already list concept is there in our Python data type, like list is a data type, you know. That means here plus can be accessed in multiple ways. So okay, that means here a plus is nothing but a operator. So that concept is called as operator overloading. Now I will tell you the example. Now, so here. This different behavior if a single operator of different types of operands is called operator overloading. That's all. The use of plus operator with different types of operands is shown below. Let me explain this program, guys. First of all, I would like to explain this concept only three lines program. Okay, so let me run these three lines first. You can see what I have given here in this example. I am giving x value is 10, x value is 10, y value is 20. If I am adding these two numbers like print of x plus y, this is just a comment line. Okay, I am giving print x plus y. Here plus is an operator. It is performing the addition operation. That means I am getting 30. 10 plus 20 is 30. That's the reason I am getting to 30. If I am giving x value 10.4, 20.5, adding floating point numbers. If I am giving x plus 4, it is also addition. You can see here 30.9. Okay, it is getting addition. Okay, so that means the plus operator can be acts like addition. If I am giving, okay, instead of x plus 5 like that, if I am giving s1 equal to hello, okay, s2 equal to world. Okay, you can take any variables, not only s1, s2, you can take x or y. That's not a problem at all. If I am giving x value hello and y value this one like that. Okay, so if I am adding two strings. That means if I am adding two strings like this, okay? Can you please tell me what is the output now? Can you please tell me what is the output now for if I am running this three lines program? What is the output of this program? Can you please tell me in the chat box? Yes, Soumya, Pravalika, good, Reshma, Divya, Ambika, Priyanka, Bhavani, Yashashwini, Shatvika, Harshita, Meher Sudha, Satya, Kamal Kumari. Okay, fine. Enough, guys. Enough. Thank you, Tejashvi and all. The answer is, you know, already hello world. Okay. If I'm running these three lines, I'm getting the answer like hello world. Okay. That means here the operator is same. The operator is same, but it is not an addition. This is not addition because whenever you are adding 20 plus 10, that is called addition. This is called concatenation. This is called concatenation. Okay. In the same way, if I'm taking, but I'm not giving some more examples here. Okay. If I'm taking list, for example, I'm giving 10 comma 20 like that. Okay. If I'm giving 10 comma 20 like that. Okay. If I'm giving L2 equal to. Okay. So if I'm giving L2 equal to, for example, I'm giving 20 comma 30. For example, if I'm giving like that. Okay. So if I'm giving print of L1 plus L2. Okay. If I'm giving print of L1 plus L2. Okay. If I'm giving print of L1 plus L2. Let me run this. I'm getting 10, 20, 20, 30. You can see, guys, here what is happening? It is not adding, it is also combining. That means it's a concatenation. Okay, that's the reason I have given in the material. You can see, guys. Okay, here you can see, guys. Here, plus operator can be used to add two numbers, concatenate two strings, or merge two lists. That means merge means that is also combining. You know already merge sort. What is meant by merge sort? Okay. That means if you are giving 10, 20, 20, 30, it will get 10, 20, 20, 30 in a single list format. If I am giving 30, 40 here, it will get like message like 10, 20, 30, 40 in a single list. 10, 20, 30, 40. That means it is merging. That means here, plus operator acts like a three different types. That means addition, concatenation, and another one is merging of two lists. So based on the data type, that means it is thinking, if you are giving a number, it is converted that x is an integer, because Python is very flexible, you know, you don't need to declare any data type, you know, okay? Here, whenever you are giving a string, that is in double quotes, it is like, it is doing like concatenation. That means addition, concatenation, and another one, if I'm giving two lists, that means because whenever you are using a square bracket, the L1 will take the data type like list, you know already. Because if you want to know print of type of L1, that is also you can give, no, it's not an issue. That means here it is a merging. That means plus can be acts like a three different types, okay? That means here plus is nothing but a operator overloaded, okay? Which operator overloaded? Addition. That means plus operator is overloaded, not addition. Plus operator is overloaded, okay? So this is the best example, guys. This is enough. If anyone giving the question in examination point of view, okay? So if you want to know anything, guys, if you want to know type of anything, print off, give L1. Print off type of L1, okay? Print off type of L1. I think you know already. I don't want to explain this one, okay? So print off type of X, okay? If I'm giving print off type of X, okay? Let me run this. It is getting class str. Class str means it is a string of, it is a, its class can be categorized as a string, because here x equal to hello. If I am giving print type of L1, okay? If I am giving print type of L1, it is a list. This class is a belongs to list, okay? So in the, for example, if I am giving print type of 20 or here 20.5, whatever it may be. So if I am giving print type of Y, it is a float, you know already, okay? So just I will run these three lines only. Okay, class float, okay? This is the way you have to get the output like this. So here, so you can see the definition now. Definitely you can understand the definition now. So operating overloading is the ability of a single operator to perform more than one operation based on the class. What is meant by class? Class is a list or a integer or a float or whatever it may be, guys. Okay, operands is nothing but variables. Here X and Y are nothing but operands. So you can see, guys, here the plus operator is operated overloaded with integer, float and string classes, okay? You can also give list also, that's not a problem. But I have not given the example in list format here, okay? So that's the reason I don't want to specify here. So the different behavior of a single operator for different types of operands is called operator overloading. That means based on the different data types, the operand, the operands of different data types, it will take the different behavior, okay? So that is nothing but operator overloading, guys, okay? So according to our syllabus, you can just see the syllabus. This is enough, guys, okay? So you don't need to go further concept. In a special interview point of view or whatever it may be. Even interview sub point of view also, it is very easy, guys, okay? Even interview point of view also, they will give the question like, what is meant by operator overloading? They will ask such questions, okay? You can see, according to our syllabus, okay, here giving like overloading operators, okay? So you can see, guys. So 1 minute, I would like to ask one question, guys. I would like to ask you one question. I think that not only plus operator is operator overloading, okay? Not only plus operator is the operator overloading. Can you please tell me any other operator which is having a arithmetic operators, for example? Yes, Priyanka, very good, absolutely. So, yes, just think about arithmetic operators, okay? We have so many types of operators, okay? Because here in Python, yes, everybody is answering. The star, that is called power star. Okay, I will tell you the example of star now, okay? But I did not mention in the notes. Let me comment this. Some students are saying that, sir, plus star is operator is called as operator overloading operator. So, star. Why star is operator overloading? For example, if I'm taking x equal to Kumar, print x into 2, okay, so and then I would like to give x value equal to 2, print x into 2. Okay, so here you can see here the plus operator. If I am running this here, if I am running the star operator here, I am getting the my name in two types, Kumar into 2. That stands for Kumar will be printed two times. You know that here star is nothing but a repetitive operator. Here star is nothing but a repetitive operator, okay? For example, if I am giving x value is 2, x into 2, how it is understanding? That means it will automatically takes based on the data type. If I am giving x value is 2, why 2 is not displayed 2 times? Because here 2 is an integer, it will perform the operation, it will give the value as 4. That is 2 to 4. Okay. Now let me run this code. I'm getting 4. Okay. I'm getting 4. So yes, Kanna, that is correct answer. Okay. So 76 Ambika, that is also right answer. Okay. So x equal to 2, print x into 2, that means it is getting 4. That means here star is a multiplication operator. Here star is a repetitive operator. So this is also an example of operator overloading, guys. It's very easy. Okay. So now I would like to move further. If you have any doubts, you can just mention in the chat box. Now, it is a more advanced topic. I think many students unable to understand even. Because in Python, we have some underscore init functions like that. We have some more built-in functions, you know. Okay. So far, we did not discuss about such methods. We just discussed about init and just underscore init. Okay. So in the same way, underscore delete. So we have seen such kind of examples until now, okay? But today I would like to discuss some more, okay? So these are only advanced concepts. I think you no need to prepare for external examination even, but I will tell you guys, okay? So can plus operator add anything? So this is the question I would like to ask you now, okay? That means if I'm giving plus operator, any numbers can add it? For example, number or whatever it may be, whatever the different adders we have in the Python. So we just think in that particular example. The answer is no. It cannot. Can you use the plus operator to add two objects of a class? That means if you're creating two objects for a particular class, if you want to add the two objects, then you are not getting the answer. I will tell you the example, don't worry. The plus operator can add two integer values, two float values, or can be used to concatenate two strings only, because these behaviors have been defined in the Python. That means that behavior already existed in the Python. So if you want to use the same operator or to add two objects of some user defined class, you should understand, then you will have to define the behavior of yourself and inform Python about that, because Python don't know that method actually. Okay. So if you are still not clear, I will tell you in a simple example, guys. Don't worry. Now I would like to give the simple example, guys. So if you got this question, operator overloading for 8 marks or anything, you can give a lot of examples with the plus and star. I did not mention about star in the notes because you have to just understand the concept. Definitely you can write the program. That's not a problem at all, I think so. Okay. So anyway, I'm discussing here, you know that we have a data type like complex, you know already, okay? Basically, you know that complex is nothing but it's a real part with the imaginary part. For example, let me take an example. If I'm giving 2 plus 3i, I would like to take another variable like c2. If I'm taking 5 plus 3i, okay, anyway, 5 plus 3i, and I'm taking 4 plus 2i. I would like to add these two. It cannot be possible by using plus operator, because plus operator can be used to add two integers, add a float, two float numbers. That is already defined by Python itself. But Python not introduces the concept how to add two complex numbers. Okay. So let me run this example, because you know that here i is one of the variable here. That means 2 plus 3i. We have to mention i also, you know already. Okay. If you want to add 2 plus 3, 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2 like that, definitely we will get the answer, you know already. Then how can we develop this program? Okay, so for let me run this code. First of all, here I'm taking c1 equal to complex of 5, 3. Here c1 is an object. Okay, you just see like that. So here complex is a class name. I'm creating the object for the particular class name. I'm giving 5, 3. That means whenever this construct, that means whenever this object is creating, so the constructor is calling the init method, and that this 5 should be stored in R, this 3 should be stored in I. That means this is the real part, this is the imaginary part. Now I am taking self.real equal to R, self.imaginary part equal to I. I am declaring like that. Okay. So now it is a C1 now. Now, in the same way, I would like to give C2, complex of 4, 2. It will take 4. Now, it is taking 2. That means if I would like to add C1 plus C2, it cannot be possible, guys. It will get the error message. It will get the error message. Let us see. I'm getting unsupported operand types. That is plus, complex, and complex. That means you cannot add two complex numbers by using addition operator. Okay. So that's the reason plus operator can then everything. That means that's the reason I have given a question like, can plus operator add anything? So I have given a question like that. Okay. The answer is no, because it is getting an error, right? Okay. Then if you want to create a add method, if you want to create a add method, then it can be executed. Okay. But in order to that means I have given an output here. So let me write output here, like output. So output give you an error, like, okay. So okay, just I'm saying the program. So we can see that plus operator is not supported in a user defined class. Okay, it is not supported in a user defined class, but we can do the same by overloading plus operator. So I will tell you how can we do that. Okay, so special functions in Python. Just now I told you underscore underscore init method. This is nothing but a special functions in Python. So the special functions are also called as magic methods. Okay, so in Python it is called as a magic methods. Okay, what are the special functions are nothing but, so whenever we have a two underscore as a prefix and suffix to the again two underscores, that is nothing but, for example, the underscore underscore init underscore method, which is also a special function. In the same way, we have some mathematical operators functions which are there in Python. So those are called as a special functions in Python. Let us introduce those functions now. So these are the various functions we have. So I'm just discussing with only arithmetic operators like that. We have for assignment operators, we have the same functions for relational operators and all. But you don't need to remember all the things, because these are a topic beyond the syllabuses actually. Okay. So that, but I would like to give you some basic understanding purpose I'm telling. Okay. Because you just understand why these are existed in our language. Okay. Let me give addition. For example, if you want to do the addition with a user-defined class, you need to define a method. You need to define a method, underscore, underscore, add, underscore, underscore, self, comma, other. Here, both are the optional parameters, but means you can give any other name. That means optional parameters means you have to give the names, okay? But means you can give like A, comma, B, that's all. You can also give A, comma, B also as well, okay? But self, comma, other means you have to give the two parameters like that, okay? So, subtraction also, underscore, sub. Division means true div. Floor division means floor div. Modulus means mod. And power means power. So these are the various operators, various functions we have. How can we use these functions in the program? Let me explain. And now I would like to discuss about only addition. So you just remember this one only. Okay. So what is the syntax? Underscore, underscore, add, underscore, underscore, self, comma, other. Okay. So I'm telling you. So overloading plus operator now. So I would like to overload plus operator with using complex. Okay, with using complex. But this is somewhat lengthy program, but don't worry. I will tell you how the program will be executed. So those lines will be common actually. I will tell you. So I'm just copying this entire code now. So this is the code actually. So let me run this program now. I would like to tell you one thing, guys. I think revision classes are going on for second CSE students. So whoever are listening, except second CS students, according to timetable, I have received only 2 hours for a week. So that is Monday and Tuesday only, okay? So you should note, guys, please, because I think most of the topics we have covered, we are already in the last topics of Unit 4, okay? So Unit 5 only exceptions related concepts, okay? But don't worry, because according to timetable, I have to tell only Monday and Tuesday. This is just a reminder to all the other than second CS students, okay? So I have revised. I have already done 2 times, and Sushma, you already asked that question. I had taken a lot of classes in C language. That's the reason I think nobody asked me to conduct the revision classes. Okay, you have given only 3 subjects for revision classes. That's the reason they assigned like that. Okay, so I think your doubt cleared. Okay, so from tomorrow, I think today and tomorrow only we have Python classes. Okay, so every week. So now let me explain this program. I'm getting sum equal to 9 + 5i. Okay, so I will tell you now. So what is the 5 3, what is 4 2? That means here I'm taking 2 complex numbers, that is 5 + 4. This is the real part. 5 + 4 is nothing but 9. Okay, so 3 + 2, what do you mean by 3 + 2? 3 + 2 is nothing but 5. So here I'm getting i, 9 + 5i. Here I'm getting the answer also, that is 9 + 5i, like that. Here how I'm getting this answer, now I will tell you with example. Okay, so this is the example I would like to tell you now. Here you just see the program of these 3 lines only. These 3 lines only. Okay, so basically here I am giving a function called underscore underscore, like that. Okay, so here I have called this function. Here I have called this function def underscore underscore add underscore underscore self comma other, according to the function which is defined in Python. This is a predefined function actually. I am not introducing this. Okay, these are the special functions in Python. These are the special functions in Python. Okay, I think you know this because just now I told you the these lines and these lines. You know already these lines, okay? Because just now I already explained the in the above example, class complex init self r comma i self dot real equal to r self dot image equal to i. So I already told you guys, okay? That means here if you are taking a 5 comma 3, it is just like a, it will store like a 5 i. But here it is just like init parameter, okay? It is just like init parameter because you know that whenever you are giving a init parameter means. It is just used to initialize the particular values. That's all. It is used to initialize the particular values. Okay. So now I am giving a add def underscore underscore add of underscore is nothing but self comma other means if I am taking r equal to self dot real plus other dot real. Okay. What will happen? And I equal to self dot imaginary plus other dot imaginary. I will tell you what will happen now. And I have given a one more method here str also. So because it is used to print the object of the particular class. For example, if I am not giving these 2 lines. It will not get any output. Okay, so let me explain each and everything. Please wait for a moment. Okay, so here now I'm giving a overload in the add operator using special functions. If I'm giving 5 comma 3, so let me explain the logic now. So if I'm giving 5 comma 3, it will take so the first that's means c1 dot real. So it will take like c1. I'm giving c1. Even if you are giving a self dot real, it will take like c1 dot real like that. Okay, so c1 dot real equal to 5, c1 dot imaginary equal to 3. So after execution of this, it will take c2 equal to complex of 4 2. Again it will go to the c2 dot real equal to, that means c2 dot real equal to, it is the value is 4. I am taking value as 4. C2 dot imaginary. That means what is the value here? 2. That means C2 dot equal to 2. So C2 dot imaginary equal to 2 now. So here you can see. So these are the two. These are the two functions I have just called by using object. This is just like a constructor. Whenever it is calling that, it is directly calling these values and it will store the values like this. If I'm giving c1 dot underscore underscore add of c2, it will going this part. Okay, it will going this part. Now it will take r equal to, that means real part, like, okay, self dot real part other dot real. Here self dot real part means other dot real part means it will take c1 dot add of c2. That means here it will take the first real part of c1. What is the first real part of c1? That is 5. Okay, so you can just see this line. And other dot real, that means self is nothing but a c1. You just think like that, okay? So other dot real is nothing but here. So other is the other one is the fourth one. That means is 4. That means what is the 5 + 4? That means 9. That means here r value is 9 now. R value is 9 now. Okay. Now I equal to self dot imaginary plus other dot imaginary. That is the what is the c1? That is what is the c1 dot imaginary value? 3. 3 + 2. That is 3 + 2 is 5. It will store the imaginary value as 3 + 2 is 5. Okay, so return complex of r i. See, just that means whenever it is calling like complex of r comma i like this. Okay, it will store the real part and imaginary part. It will return like means 9, 5. Now it will return 9, 5. But here how it will return? That means here it will execute the inbuilt method like def_str. Till now we did not discuss about this. This is also one of the special function we have. What is this function? What is this function meaning? I will tell you now. Okay. Here I am giving str of self.real. Now what is the result we have? This is the 9, 5. Now 9 is the real part, 5 is the imaginary part. You know already. Here string format it is showing because you are declaring 2 means it is an integer. If I am giving 2 + 3i means it is just like we have to take a data type like string only, because we want to get the output like sum equal to 9 + 5i. Here 9 + i 5i means it should be taken like a string only. So that's the reason I have taken a string function again. So it will return the self.real. That means it will take the 9. Okay, here it will take the first parameter as 9 and it will print plus. It will print plus. Here the plus operator is printed like this. Okay, it is not a plus addition operator. Okay, it is just like a adding because it is a string. It is a combining operator. Okay, it is a combining operator. That means it is a concatenation operator. Now I am giving self.imaginary. What is the self.imaginary? 5. That means 9 + 5. And including you have to print I also. That means it is also printing 5i. That means again you have to give plus and it is in a single quotation I. So it is printing 9 + 5i. Okay. 9 + 5i. That's the reason we are getting the 9 + 5i. Okay. So this is the way you have to understand, guys. But these are very lengthy. These are the not, you no need to study all the things. Okay. So you are getting like 9 + 5i like that. You can take any numbers. You don't need to take these values only. You can take any values. You can take 15. Okay. You can take 15 and 13. Okay. Let me run this now. So I will take like this. I will get the output like this. Okay. So this is the way you have to understand, guys. So if I'm giving c1.underscore_c2, it is calling the addition. Okay. Here basically where it is executing here, this is the logic actually. So here it is adding the 2 complex numbers like this. Okay. So these are the extra functions we have. Just to understand the concept. You can also do the same way like subtraction, multiplication also. You can do in this way. Okay. And you can also give c1 plus c2 also. In that case also it will be automatically executed that method. Okay. That is the flexibility of this function. If I am giving c1 plus c2, c2 will call the method add automatically. This is the excellent feature we have. So if I am running this code, I will get sum equal to 39 + 38i like that. Okay. So here sum equal to c1 plus c2 I am giving. That means here I am not giving underscore function add. So it is calling automatically. Okay. So that's the flexibility we have. That means this is an alternative for addition. This is an alternative for addition. Yeah. That's all. Okay. So I have given everything. Why I use underscore function. Why I using str function. Okay. So it is just format for object printing. That is short bill for printing. All I have given. I have taken a str function. Okay. So now I will move to the concept like polymorphism in Python. So actually I'm not going on the syllabus order because so whenever I'm giving a inheritance concept, I would like to tell overriding concept as well. But basically he is giving the inheritance and polymorphism here. So I would like to skip these topics. Okay. And I'm discussing about polymorphism concept for understanding of inheritance, because if you just know what is an inheritance now. So if I tell the polymorphism also, definitely you can understand what is a polymorphism now. So that's the reason I would like to skip these topics. I will tell after completion of these topics definitely. Okay. So let me explain now. So what is a polymorphism? So polymorphism, according to the definition itself, poly means many. So morphism means it's a forms. So it means so many forms. That's the basic definition of polymorphism is this is a many forms. Okay. So poly means many, morphism means forms. Okay. So there is multiple forms. So polymorphism is a concept of object-oriented programming, which means multiple forms are more than one form. That means it is also somewhat similar to like operator overloading. That's the reason I would like to take this concept now itself. Okay. So because it is just like an operator overloading, but here the polymorphism can be acting in different ways. So I would like to discuss this concept now. So it refers to the use of single type entity, that is method or operator or object. So far we have discussed about only operator overloading. See, here you can also overload methods. You can also overload classes, whatever it may be, or even methods and functions, whatever it may be. Okay. So here let's take an example. First, Python like Python polymorphism in addition operator. Okay, so let me take an addition operator. Just now I already discussed, you know, already. So we know that plus operator used extensively in Python programs, but it does not have a single usage. It can use in multiple ways. Okay, so for example, if you're giving a number 1 equal to number 2 equal to 1 and 2, if I'm giving number 1 equal to 1 and number 2 equal to 2, if I'm giving print of number 1 plus number 2, it will print the value as 3, because output is 3. Okay, so that means 1 plus 2 is 3. Similarly, if for string data types, plus operator used to perform concatenation. That means str n equal to Python and str2 equal to programming. Str n plus str2, it will give the space now. If you want to give space like that, okay, I'm just giving space. Okay. So it will print like as a result, it will print Python programming. So you already know what is a plus operator and all. Okay, so here this is also called as polymorphism. This means operator, the plus operator is acting like many forms. Okay, this is also polymorphism actually. Okay, so polymorphism means one can be act as a multiple forms based on the situation. Okay, so this is nothing but a polymorphism. So 1 minute, I would like to discuss one more thing about polymorphism, because you may confuse operator overloading and polymorphism. Now I will tell you. So here you can see the plus operator, it can be performed in multiple ways. Okay, this is one of the most simplest occurrences of polymorphism in Python. I already told this. Okay, now I would like to discuss about function polymorphism in Python. I just now told about only operator polymorphism like that. Now I will tell you function polymorphism. What is function polymorphism? For example, if you know what is a len, I think you know already. For example, if you're getting a question like write a program to print the length of a given string. For example, if you're getting a such question. Okay, so basically in C language, we have a function called strlen. Okay, so for example, I'm giving name equal to. Okay, so I'm giving name equal to input of enter your name. So I'm giving a simple question called, okay, so for example, I would like to print the length of a given name. Okay, so I'm giving the length of your name is comma len of name. I'm just giving this example. Okay, so if anybody asks the question in write a program to print the that means we print the length of a given name, for example, given string, whatever it may be. Okay, so let me run this code. So if I'm giving this enter your name, it will ask like this. I'm giving comma, the length of your name is 5. This is a very easy program. You can just do in a single two lines of a code. Okay, so that means here you no need to declare like a character like that, you know already, because in C language you need to specify char name of 20. So that means the name allows up to 20 characters. Again, you have to space printf enter your name. Again, you have to take scan of percentage, ampersand s like that. So then you have to give the length of your name is strln. That means that percentage d you have to give. That means many students are confusing about when you are printing the first name. Everybody, you just think like many students are giving like percentage s, and they will get the wrong answer, because basically when you are getting a return type as integer, you have to give percentage d. In strings, many students are confusing percentage s, percentage d like that. There is no confusion in Python, you know already. Okay, that means here length is a function. It will print the string length. Okay, but the length having so many, you can use in different ways. For example, I'm using, I'm giving like 1 minute. I'm just giving like program like that. Okay, so 1 minute, one, how many characters we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I'm just giving 7 here. I will just copy this. Okay, so now I'm running the code. You can see here in the first time I'm using len of program. That means how many characters we have in program? We have 7 characters. Okay, we have 7 characters. In the same way, if I'm giving len of Python comma Java comma C, this is actually a list, because I'm giving in a list format. That is square brackets. Okay, I'm getting 3, because how many list items are there? 3 items are there. Okay, see here how many key items are there. Name is one key, address is one key. This is a dictionary, you know already, key value pairs. Okay, you can also use in sets, you can also use in tuples. That means it is displaying, len function is displaying based on the function we are having. That means based on the data type, it will act like that. Okay, that means here length function is a polymorphism operation. That means it can be act like a many forms. So this is also one of the example, guys. Okay, so this is just nothing but a, because here len is not a operator, it is not a operator of overloading. Okay, so just understand the difference between operator of overloading and polymorphism. Okay, so one can be act as a multiple forms or nothing but polymorphism, that's all. Okay, so here you can see list tuple, whatever it may be, it's not a list. I have just given it for your understanding purpose. I have taken only three. Okay, so you just use that function only. So this is just nothing but a polymorphism functionality. So you just think this diagram, polymorphism in len function in Python. If you're taking a len, if you're taking a string, it will print the length of the string. If you're taking a list, it will print the number of items. It will take the dictionary, it will print the number of keys we have. So that means here length function can be worked with different instances with different times. It will acts like a, but it will get the same result only. Okay, so this is a polymorphism in length function. It is a len is a predefined function, you know already. Let me introduce with the user defined function. Okay, I will define with user defined function with what is a polymorphism. Okay, I think up to this is enough, guys. If you'd like to write an examination point of view, you just understand up to example three. That's all. That is very easy. Okay. So I have given a in-depth concept in example four. Okay. If you are understand, definitely you can write the examination. You can write in examination. Don't worry. Definitely you will understand. No worry. So let me explain example three as well. You can see, guys. Here I have given user-defined function. So like length, I'm giving a function like add. Here add is not a predefined. Okay. Here add is not a predefined. I have given a add function like that. Okay. If I would like to give addi, also it will perform. Okay. Just now I discussed about __ add. That is a predefined function. Okay. This is user-defined function. I can define with any name. Addi. I am defining like that. Okay. For your understanding purpose, I just renamed the string value like addi. Okay. So let me introduce now. So print of addition of 2, 3. I have given only two parameters, but I have given three parameters in the function. That means this is called function. You know already. This is calling function. So whenever I am giving 2, 3, it is basically I have given z equal to 0, because you know already in C language and Java. So you no need to. That means you cannot have this syntax in this called function. That means in called function you have to give only variable names only. Okay. Even you don't have the chance to give like constants or expressions in C language and Java. That is very important bit actually. Okay, that means called function variables are dash. Okay, those are only variables only. Okay, that means the called function arguments are dash. That is variables only. So you cannot give constants, you cannot give expressions and all. Okay, but here you can give. Python having a flexible feature. We have, I'm giving z equal to 0, but I have passed only two arguments. Even if you giving the same function, it will get the error message in C language, because here it takes two arguments, it is taking three arguments, it will get the error like that. But if you're taking 2, 3, so it will execute x value is 2, y value is 3, and z equal to 0 automatically. Okay, so if you are taking only two parameters even. So here x plus y plus z means it is printing, it will print 2 + 3 as 5. So the output will be 5 now. Then I'm calling addition function again. It is defining 2, 3, 4. That means 2 + 3 + 4. That means even though you are giving z equal to 0, whenever you are assigning a 4, that means 4 will be replaced by 0. That means z value is 4 now. So what is the 2 + 3 + 4? That is the value is 9. So that means you will get the output as 5 and 9. That means the value means you will get the value like 5 and 9 only. You will get the output like 5 and 9 only. Okay. So let me run this. Okay. So here, which is the polymorphic behavior? Addition method is the polymorphic behavior, because based on the number of constants, that means based on the number of parameters you are giving, even though you are giving a 2, 3, when you are giving 2, 3, 4, it is getting the addition. You are getting the output like 5, 9, like that. Okay, 5 ( 9, like that. Okay, so this is the way you have to understand. This is nothing but a polymorphic. So I think you are able to understand what is a polymorphism now. Now let me introduce the in-depth concepts now. Polymorphism in class functions. Okay, so first of all, imagine that means these are somewhat critical, and the main advantage of polymorphism means you can reduce the code, as like in the inheritance also you can reduce the code, you can reuse the code as well, you know already. In the same way, for example, if you're defining one function, you no need to define a function multiple times. Okay, that means you can use that functions in different classes with different functionalities like that. Okay, so you just imagine a situation now. I'm having a classes like a different classes with shapes like a square, triangle, etc., which are such a resource to calculate the area of that shape. Okay, that means I would like to calculate the area of a particular shape. Okay, so each shape has a different number of dimensions which are used to calculate the area of the respective shape. So now I would like to take an example now. So I would like to take one example. It's a very easy example actually. So just understand this logic. I don't want to execute now. So I will tell you afterwards. 1 minute. Okay. You just see guys. First I am giving a sq equal to square. Here sq is an object. It is for square. It means it is a for square class. Okay, I'm creating an object for a square class. So whenever I'm giving a square like this, okay, whenever I'm giving square like this, okay, so try equal triangle. So it is executing the square functionalities like that. Okay, but here I'm not giving define like that. I'm not giving define like that. So it will not execute anything. It will just create the object like that. Okay, so because I'm not given anything. So here I have given side equal to 5 like that only. Okay, so now you can see here, I'm after completion of the object creation, sq and try, it will execute the area of square. Here I have given sq dot calculate underscore area underscore square. That means calculate underscore area underscore square root means it will execute this function. That means it will go to this part now. Return self dot side into self dot side. That means you know, that means square root, that means for example, if you're taking a square, so what is the area? That means 5 square, you know already, okay? So how to calculate the area? So that means if you are taking a square value as 5, that means the answer is 25. 5 square is 25. Okay, that's the reason I have given a self dot side into self dot side. So this is the functionality we have. Whenever it is getting written, it will print like this. So that means area of square is 25. It will display like this. Now area of triangle. Now it will print, it will take the function as tri. Here the difference is it is tri, it is sq. Okay, you understand the difference now. So here I am giving try means, so it will execute the off BH, because triangle formula for area means off BH, you know already. Okay, off means 0.5 into self dot base into self dot height. Okay, I have given 5 and 4 like this. Okay, so that means half into 5 into 4, that means half into 5 into 4 like that means so 2 to 4, that means answer is maybe 10. Okay, so it will print the area of triangle is 10. It will be displayed like that. Here, the drawback is, for example, if you understand the simple program in this example, every time if you are calling a method like calculate area square, calculate area try, you have to remember those names. You have to remember those names. Okay, that means, for example, if you would like to print, if you would like to do a big website like that, if you have multiple functions, for example, take any real time example. If you want to write a piece of code for building a website like that, you need to declare multiple functions. Okay, if you want to remember all the function names, it is a simple program, so it is easily understandable, guys. Okay, so let me copy this. So this is class methods. Okay, this is the difference. Here earlier I have used like in regular method, it is not a class. You just understand, guys. Okay, so it is a class methods. Now I'm explaining the class methods like that. Okay, so let me run this code. So now I'm getting area of square is 25, area of triangle is 10.0. okay, of BH like that, it is getting like that. So that is correct answer only. But here there is no polymorphism actually. Okay, because so every time is getting is different functions only. Now you can see the problem here. You can see all these lines. The problem with this approach is the developer, that means I am the developer, for example, okay, a developer has to remember the name of the each function separately. Okay, for example, if I would like to find the rectangle also, that means I have to write a code again. I have to remember the function name. In a much larger program, it is very difficult to memorize the name of the functions for every small operation. Okay, here comes the role of method overloading. Okay, so here the concept is introducing like method overloading like that. Here that means if you're taking a method with a single name, You can call the particular method again and again. Okay. So with the different parameters like that. Okay. So now actually, so Python does not support method overruling, but it's just like a sample piece of understanding purpose. I'm telling. So I will tell you about the tomorrow. So what is the method overruling and all? Now let's change the name of the functions. Calculate the area and give the both same name like calculate underscore area. That means in order to give SQ calculate area underscore SQ calculate area underscore try, I'm just giving like calculate underscore area for both the classes and with different functions. Okay. So how could we resolve this problem? Now let me explain this. Okay. So you can see the code now. Okay. So the same program. Here I'm giving calculate underscore area. I'm giving calculate underscore area. Okay. Same program. Nothing is changed. Okay. Here I'm giving SQ, that means object name dot calculate area. Okay. So try dot calculate area. I'm not using like underscore again SQI like that. I did not use anything. Okay. You can just see the program here. Here I have given an extra line called SQ try. These are not part of the polymorphism, because polymorphism means one can be attached to multiple forms based on the instance. Okay. Here one class is there. Here the function name is different. Here one other class is there. Another function is different. But if you want to give the same function name for the the same function bodies, okay, you can define like that. Okay, so let me run the program with that example. It will not get any error message, guys. Okay, so let me run this code now. Okay, you can see, guys. So we will get the same output. Okay, I'm getting 25, I'm getting 10.0. So what is the difference between the above program and this program? I have given sq equal to square. That means here I'm not giving init method, so it will take. That means here I'm not passing any objects. Okay, I'm not passing any values here in the arguments. Okay, so sq is the one of the object, try is the triangle object. I'm giving area of a square is sq dot calculate underscore area. That means calculate underscore is the only function we have. Okay. That means here I am giving, in square class also I am giving calculate underscore area. So that is the same function name. I am not using like extra like a square like that I am using. Okay. So here I am using calculate underscore area again. So that means the same function name is repeated in two classes. Okay. Like add method, addition method we have in the previous example. Okay. So here the triangle triangle area is printing, square area is printing. If I would like to add a rectangle here, you can definitely add this code and you can just call the method. You no need to remember all the method names. That's the reason we have the Python polymorphism concept came into the existence. Okay. I think you hope you understand, guys. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you just mention in the chat box. So I just explained, like as you see in the implementation of both the classes, square as well as triangle has the function with same name, calculate area. But due to different objects, it's called get resolved correctly. Okay. That means because based on the objects only it will execute it. Okay. So that's the reason here I have given sq dot. Here it is getting like try dot. So whatever it may be, based on the objects only it is getting executed like that. Okay. So that is when the function is called using the square object, the square is called. When it is called using the try object, that means it is calling the triangle. That's all. So basically you just remember the names. So it is very easy, guys, compared to the any other thing. Okay. So this is nothing but a polymorphism in Python. Okay. So definitely I will explain the method overloading. Method overloading cannot be possible in Python because you know there is no function parameters like integer a, float b. You no need to write like this in this Python actually. So that's the reason it is not supported. Anyway, I will discuss tomorrow, don't worry. So but actually most of the topics we covered. So I think fourth unit also we have covered almost 85% almost. Okay. So try to revise all the concepts, guys, because if you have any doubts, so definitely you can ask me. No worry. Okay. I'm just sending the feedback form link. You can just go through that. Just fill the form. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me. I will be there here for a few minutes. So this is up to polymorphism and operator overloading concepts today. And I would like to discuss one more thing here. Actually, in the syllabus, they have to mention like overriding actually. Here in syllabus, it is mentioned like overlapping. Okay. So according to inheritance concept, he has to give overriding actually. Okay. he is giving overlapping actually, okay? So actually overlapping is not similar to overriding, okay? So because if you just think if I'm opening Google also, I'm just opening Google, okay? So overlapping and overriding, he is just giving overlapping. 1 minute, let me copy this. Overlapping and overloading operators, okay? Let me give like this. So I'm just giving like this, okay? So I'm just giving in Python, okay? I'm just adding like in Python. Okay, so you can see here, everything you will get like here. Yeah, no problem. So you can see here, you can think like just it is getting like overlapping and overloading. It will show only overloading only. It will not show any overlapping concept, okay? Even Google not having that concept. But why is he taking like that? I don't know. Okay. So I think it is overriding my thinking like that. Okay. So for example, if I'm giving I will remove the operators here. Okay. If I'm just removing operator, because overloading operators is new concept actually. Okay. So I'm just giving overlapping in Python like that. Okay. So if I'm giving overlapping in Python, it is just like a function he is creating. It is only just like a overlapping in the function name is overlapping. It is just like assignment question actually. So someone is posted there, okay? So there is no overlapping concept actually. I think I'm thinking like it is a overriding only. So okay, so if you got the concept anyway, definitely you just intimate me, no problem. I think it is just like a overriding. I think I forgot to give like a overlapping. So it is programming using OOPS concept. That means whatever the programs I'm discussing about the OOPS concept, these are the nothing but the concept actually. Here we have only real-time classes. That means whatever the projects we have using like ATM, this is a real-time use of a class. Means whenever you are using a real-time projects, how we are creating a class, I will tell you in that way, don't worry. Basically we have only two concepts in maximum, two or three concepts only there in unit 4, that's all, okay? So and compared to real-time programming core Python, it is object-oriented Python is having some flexible features for us, because you are thinking like if you want to create a new website like that, you need to go for a object-oriented programming only, okay? Because by using core Python, you can only develop a mobile apps, that's all, okay? By using core Python, that means core Python means core concept like that, you don't need to develop a website like that, okay? So object-oriented concepts are very easy actually. So that means you have to understand the concept, that's all. So what is the inheritance, what is a polymorphism, if you understand in that way, it is very easy, guys. Okay, so Vishnu, you is asking some doubt here. So actually, whenever you are adding two complex numbers, it will not be possible actually. Okay, so in class especially, if I am giving a class especially, so you cannot add the two complex numbers in a particular class. Okay, so because basically, whenever you are giving your addition operator, it will be possible only in a particular like you define variables like that. If you want to use that, you can use in that way. But if you want to perform a addition operation, okay, so you just give some methods like add self comma other. This is a predefined function actually. You just go through the Google also, don't no worry. Okay, it is a predefined function. I have not created that actually. So this is a special functions in Python actually. You just go through this. So definitely we'll get like this. Okay, Python Guru is one of the website we have. Okay. So I have referred a lot of websites, okay. So it will show like that. Okay. So you just open this, no problem. The pythonguru.com, okay, anyway, so let me open this. Okay, you can see here, so he is adding like add like this, okay, he is giving another parameter like other, so whatever it may be, it's not other only, you can take any parameter. Let me open this example. So if you have any doubts, you can just ask me in the chat box, Vishnu, no worry. You can just see the example now. So I have created this code actually. So here it is for adding a two complex numbers. Okay. So here I'm using the c1.underscore parameter like that. If I'm giving, I'm not giving other parameter like, okay, I'm not giving other parameter like that. So I would like to give like, num2 Okay, if you're confusing about that add parameter, I will give you another example. Don't worry. Num1. You just think in that way. That's better, I think. But you just thinking like, if I'm giving num1 comma num2, you may confuse that here 15 is a num1, 13 is a num2. You will decide like that. That's the reason only I have given a same sample structure, because you can take the parameters as well. Okay, because here self is nothing but a first parameter like that. If I'm taking a real parameters, means it is a real parameter. So other dot real means it is a real part for this. Okay, I don't give number one, number two. You may confuse. So I will give like s e l f like that. I am giving s e. Okay. That means you can take any variable. That's not a, those are not predefined. Okay. He like self parameter, we have to give two parameters. Okay, I'm giving same. Okay, I'm not changing anything. I'm just changing those two parameters only. I'm running the code. Okay, 39 plus 38a. What is the change in this? Okay, it is just according to syntax I have given. Okay, so self comma other, that means it is taking like two parameters, self comma other like that. It is taking the first parameter. For example, if I'm taking this program, so complex of 15 comma 13. Okay, so complex of 15 comma 13 means it will take the 15 into real part and 13 into imaginary part. But here basically it will take self dot real means it will take the C1 object. That means C1 dot real is nothing but 15. C1 dot imaginary is nothing but 13. You have to think like that. Okay. If I'm giving like this, if you are giving C2, it is taking like 24 is the real part, 25 is the imaginary part. That is C2. So I am calling this function now. C1 underscore address underscore C2. So this is the function I'm giving, C1 dot, that means here I'm giving C1 is an object, okay, dot underscore underscore C2. So this is just calling function, because I'm adding two complex numbers in it, okay, C1 underscore C2 like that, okay. So it is calling this add function now. Even though you're giving a C1 plus C2 also, it will execute it. I already told you, okay. You don't need to give all this code to remember all these things, okay. Because whenever you're giving a plus operation, so it will call the add function, because this is a specific function which is created for addition. So that's the reason I have to explain the table. I have explained this table. This is addition plus underscore underscore add underscore self other. So like you can perform subtraction, modular division, power and all. Okay. So if you don't have any doubts, you can leave, guys. No issue. Some students are sending. Okay. Now you can see. Here, now it will add function, it will take r equal to sc dot real plus ot dot real. That means it will take the first real part and the c1 real part and c2 real part. It will store the addition in this variable. Okay. So what is the c1 plus c2? That means real part 15 plus 24. That is 39. Here, what is the other value? 13 plus 25. Now it is imaginary. What is the 25 and 13 and 25? 38. So now I'm giving return of complex comma r comma I. That means now these are the functions of, that means it is the complex function. Now it is 39 comma 28, 38. It will store like that, complex of 39 comma 38. But it will not print anything. I'm giving return statement. Okay. So whenever it is calling, I am giving one more function like print object of complex. Okay. That means if you want to print the string like 39 plus 38 I like that, you have to give that value like that 39 is the real part and plus it will give the plus message. That means here plus is in a single quote. That means it will print it like plus here. And str of self.imaginary, then it will print the 38 part and it will print the I. That's all. You just remove these two lines, you definitely understand what will happen. Okay. So I will just send the notes. Don't worry. If you are still having any doubt, you can just mention Vishnu. No problem. Okay. Thank you, Vishnu. No problem. So if you have any doubts, I will be here within 5 minutes. You can just post any message, no issue. And especially I would like to tell you one thing, guys, prepare well for 1-2 subjects first. After that, you can prepare this, because most probably 2-1 subjects examination will not be in the month of November or October. Okay, so you know already, it is impossible even, because you have to complete two mid examinations for first year 1-2, and you have to complete the external examination, and again you have to complete the 2-1 mid examinations and all. Okay, that means it will take hardly, I think December it may be. Okay, so that's the reason I'm telling. That's the reason only today also they conduct the meeting in the college itself. I have attended the meeting actually. So that's the reason I'm telling guys. Okay, so because we are already in the fourth unit ending, that means we have only fifth unit. That's all. So almost. Okay. So that's the reason. So we are having almost end of the syllabus. They just allotted only two subjects. So that means 2 hours only for a day like that. But of course, I'm able to teach, but according to the timetable, I have to go through. I already asked the HOD sir again. Okay, no problem. Anyway, what will happen? So if you have any doubts, you just ask me, guys. No problem. And prepare well for examinations. Okay, so because today also finally students are having examination, you know already. And I especially told you. So I think yesterday and day before yesterday, we are having holidays. Actually, I'm giving Dasara holidays like that. But I'm not having any Dasara holidays today. Even we are conducting TCS campus, you know already. Okay, and I would like to post those questions in your WhatsApp chat. Okay, WhatsApp group actually. So why? Because you just gone through the example programs. Okay, how they are asking. Okay, how they are asking the programs in TCS examination. You just see that. Okay, I will just post after completion of the class in Python group also. I will post, guys. Just see. Okay, that means why program means here. Why I am telling like car examples like that. Such questions will ask in the interview point of view like that. Okay, that means in TCS interview, so some website is going on FaceClip, one of the website we have. So that means all the examination questions will be posted there actually. So he is also sending the same questions to me personally. So I will post those questions. Okay, you just go through the examples. So because whenever you are entering into the third year itself, the TCS is recruiting the candidates from third year itself. Okay, you just understand how they are giving the question, because they are not giving the questions like a reverse number, finding the length of a string like that. Those are very easy. Okay, how the concepts are thinking, how the concepts are going in that way, you just think that question. So I just forward after completion of the class. So because if I'm forwarding this, why he is sending in this WhatsApp group, you will think like that. That's the reason I'm telling now. Okay, so anyway, happy stay home, stay safe, guys. Bye bye, take care. So nobody is asking any doubts.